Guys, everything's working right now. Finally. So, finally.
After how many months?
It's been like 3 months.
It's been ridiculous.
Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and we got the boss here today to play some Sailor Moon with us. I got you this game because I know you like Sailor Moon.
I love it.
We played like a week ago, and all the audio was trashed, so...
We're going to do it again.
Yeah,
we're going to keep it tight. And
keeping it tight. We're in Mexico right now.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Bien, ¿y tú?
Muy bien, gracias.
Yeah, sí.
Player one, Serena.
Okay, let's see. I'll go here.
Mercury.
I'm going to try to not ask you the same questions as we did last time.
It's okay if you do. Because we'll just pretend.
There's going to be a couple there. Yeah, like it didn't happen. But I'm going to, that episode's going to come out later.
It is?
I wanted the first episode with you to be like crisp.
Oh, okay.
So the audio working well, the game working well. Yeah, I want it to be crisp, but that episode was so good.
It was so good.
And so maybe like in a few months, we'll just put out a disclaimer like, hey, the audio sounds like there's an earthquake. So if you, if you want to watch it, you can. It's here for you if you really want to see it. So something like that. Okay, so getting started. You've got a very wide fan base of anime kids, cartoon kids.
Of everybody.
All sorts of stuff. You obviously were into this stuff when you were a child.
Yes.
And it's bridged over into your current lifestyle. What kind of stuff did you watch back in the day?
Yeah. of course, my first anime had to be Sailor Moon. I remember it would always play at like 6 in the morning. And when I was a kid,
Why were you up at 6 in the morning?
Dude, I have no idea. But I was always so confused at what time because it was always dark. So I remember staying up all night till 6 in the morning.
What?
Just thinking, I have to watch Sailor Moon.
Why wouldn't you just go to sleep and wake up?
I couldn't tell time. I didn't realize. I just remembered it always came on at night, really, really late, and then like an hour later the sun will come out, and I was like, what time is that, Mom?
Yeah.
But it was Sailor Moon, and then my love for anime just grew and grew and grew, and I freaking love it. I love anything anime. I love anything Korean. I'm obsessed with Korean movies.
Like in K-pop as well?
K-pop, J-pop.
Do you listen to SHINee?
I listen to everything, yes.
SHINee is my band.
It's so good.
And I don't know, I'm obsessed.
I'm obsessed with them. I'm obsessed with Epic High right now.
Okay, I haven't heard of Epic High.
Oh, it's so good.
Is it
so
girls
cute.
Or guys?
It's guys.
Okay, got some Asian thing going
on. I have an Asian fever, that's for sure.
Asian
fever.
Why do you have to say it like that?
I don't know.
What kind of stuff are you watching now, anime-wise?
Anime? I'm back to watching School Rumble again, and it's like my probably 20th time watching it because I'm obsessed with it.
Jesus.
Attack of the Titans.
Okay, yes, Attack on Titans is fantastic.
And I just started Game of Thrones. I know we talked about that last
time. We did. You finally started it, though.
Today.
Like, just now.
Oh my god, it's so good.
Right? What episode are you on?
2.
Okay.
Just today.
Okay. But I mean, you may have, we went to the gym, but then after that, I don't know what you've been doing.
You
may have just been watching Game of Thrones.
It's so good.
It's amazing. You gotta read the books too. Well, at least
I don't
the first.
Sorry.
Like, can't or won't?
I can't read, but I just refuse to.
So then what's your favorite Asian movie?
Of all time is Oldboy. Have you seen that one?
Oh my god, yes. Oh my god, yes,
I love
Oldboy.
You.
Dude.
Oh my god, have you seen The Chaser?
Yes.
I saw The Devil?
Yes. God. So many good movies. So many good movies. Can we talk about Oldboy for a second?
Okay, yes.
Okay, spoilers. Maybe, no spoilers because like, I don't know if we can.
It's really good.
We can't even talk about that on this show,
no.
The way it ends. Dude, okay, so I saw the American one, the American one first, which you didn't like?
I refuse to watch it.
Why?
I can't watch remakes.
I'm telling you, most of the time they're not good. This is fantastic.
No, I heard it was terrible.
From who?
Everybody.
No.
No.
No! From me first.
Okay, but first of all, it's my favorite movie of all time, so I refuse to watch it.
Okay, well, then maybe it's your favorite movie of all time. Oh my god. Ooh, Korean horror movies, Japanese horror movies.
Oh, so good.
What's the one? I don't remember what it's called, but it's like this girl gets eye transplants.
The eye.
Yes.
No, yeah.
Okay.
Is that the one?
I think that is the eye. It's amazing. And she starts seeing all the ghosts and everything.
Yeah, and that's the movie that got me started to like Asian movies.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so that got you started.
Yeah.
When did you watch that? When you were young? You freaked out?
When I was 12, I remember.
What?
Yeah.
You were watching horror movies like that when you were 12?
Yeah. That's
a lot.
I just remember seeing that. I was like,
okay, do you speak any Asian languages?
Anaseo.
What?
Anaseo.
Anaseo?
Anaseo.
Anaseo?
Yeah,
what is
that's
that?
Like hello in Korean.
Oh, okay.
And then I know,
So no, you don't.
No, I don't.
What kind of kid were you? Were you like outgoing, or were you shy?
I was both in a way, because I love wrestling and I love nerdy stuff. So people thought I was weird yet cool at the same time. Mm-hmm. And then I started to go to online school when I was in seventh grade. So then I became a loser. No social life, nothing.
I go to online school.
Okay, but you still have friends. This is when I was like 13, and then just...
Why did you start going to online school then?
My brother had disabilities, and he was getting abused in school. Sad story. And I didn't want my mom to leave work because she just got a job. So I'm like, I'll leave school to take care of him and be a good person
that
I am today.
That's awesome.
So that's what I did. And then I finally found wrestling at a training school when I was 18. And then I was just like, finally, people who love what I do. And so, yeah, that's my little life story.
And do you feel like that experience helped you kind of become like who you are today, in a sense?
Yeah.
Because like, you're a very kind, caring person.
I feel like you know? I'm a mom.
Yeah.
Because of that, and I don't mind it.
Yeah, it's not a bad thing. I feel like there's lots of people who wish they had qualities like that, but they don't necessarily have them, because it's hard to kind of come across like people who are genuinely caring a lot of the time.
I feel like yes and no, because I honestly feel like I'm 40 years old.
Yeah.
Sometimes, but now I get to live my life and play video games. Yeah. So I still have the kid inside.
It's a good mix.
Yes. Not like that though. I ain't that weird.
Okay, so then this is also fairly recent. You having that Iron Woman match.
Whew.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah. How sick is that? First female main event.
Ever. Like, I'm trying to change the world.
Yeah.
World peace and wrestling for women's wrestling.
Yeah, right?
It's so
getting it done.
I don't understand life sometimes. It's insane.
It's wild.
First Brooklyn, and we did so well in Brooklyn that they had to give us the name.
Yeah.
You know?
That was unreal.
I just don't know what to do anymore with myself.
I legit, and I told you this, I'm going to tell them this. Like, I was watching that match with Breeze, and we're talking about the next day, and I was like, that's the best wrestling match I've seen in a long time. Mm-hmm. And then he was like, we sat there for a few minutes and he was like, I think that might be the best match I've ever seen. And then I thought about it too and I was like,
that's
weird. I really think that might be the best wrestling match I've ever seen in my life.
No.
Yeah.
You can't tell me that. That's so, no.
Because honestly, like, okay, so let's take any match from back in the day. Like, I had like childhood nostalgia, like emotions towards it because I love wrestling so much. But like, this is different for me because like, I don't necessarily get that anymore. I get it with certain moments, so like, let's say like when Undertaker lost at Mania, it was like, oh my God, childhood is crumbling in front of my, like, you get that like kind of hype, but being in it, it's so much harder to get those moments. But like, you guys, you're both young, you're both hungry, you're both so talented with what you guys do in and out of the ring. So knowing you guys on a personal level, I have an attachment there, but then like, just like you said, for female wrestling in general, like you guys are completely changing the game and you're showing everyone, like you're literally showing the world, like you guys need to be put on a pedestal just like everybody else, because you're just as good, you can do everything just as well, and like people get into it just as much. And so like all of that combined like gives me feels. I don't know, there's my gush. Oh my God, please cry on the show.
No. I always cry. People drive me crazy, they say I cry too much.
You?
Which can I say something?
You can
I've
say
only
you want.
Cried three times, so I'm sick of getting tweets, stop crying.
People, but think about it. Those three times you've cried have been
the first
very
time,
replayable moments.
Right, and the first time was against me versus Charlotte, and mm-hmm. I thought that was my last NXT match.
Oh,
the second time was at Brooklyn, and I thought that was my last NXT match.
Yeah.
So then, main eventing, and I cried. Dude, give me a break. I just made
it's emotional.
It. Like,
it's emotional.
Get out of here.
We'll just finish this stage out, and then we'll go.
We got it right now.
Oh, you died.
I'm dead.
Oh, well.
I won one level.
We just.
I was just.
That's right, I was just
pretending attention. Just like going like this.
Here.
And I'm like, game over.
Here, get it.
No, I'm pissed.
Well, I can like straight interview now.
Yeah.
So, Sasha.
Yes.
Oh, excuse me, boss. I get make everybody get these nicknames and then I always forget to use them.
That's okay.
I'm horrible at this. What are you looking most forward to? Like, do you play tons of video games now? Well, not tons, because I know we travel a lot, but are there any video games you're looking forward to? Any new animes you're looking forward to? What's on the horizon in your mind that you're looking for?
Anything, honestly. I just want to have the time to watch stuff, because I haven't in so long, and I miss it.
Yeah.
There's, like, this feel that you get from, like, watching this stuff.
Yeah.
So anything that's new, like, just tweet me, and I'll try to watch
it. Send her everything.
Hi, Crunchyroll. I'll just go to Crunchyroll, right?
Please, yes. I'm trying to get that subscription so bad.
They're so good.
They're amazing. Mm. Crunchyroll's so sick. The next week, animes that are fresh out in Japan just come over subtitled. She doesn't necessarily watch the subtitled stuff because she's...
I only watch subtitles in the movies.
Okay, but we got to go because we got to go do the show tonight. We got to get some food and all that stuff. But, boss, thank you.
Thank you, Lindsay. We finally did it. We broke the curse.
Oh, my God. It feels so good. So, make sure that you follow me on Twitter, at Xavier Woods, PhD. Make sure you follow the boss on Twitter.
Sasha Banks, WB.
Make sure you follow the channel, at UpUpDownDown on Instagram and Twitter. That's at UpUpDownDown without the O's. Like, subscribe, all this good stuff. We finally got your girl on the show. It feels good. I'm happy.
I'm happy. Need to do a tournament sometime.
Yes. Okay. You got to get in.
I'll come back.
We're going to get her in for a tournament. But like I said, like, subscribe, all that stuff. Please, please do it.
Get them over.
We hit 200,000 subscribers the other day. And
woo!
Oh, my God. If we can hit 250 by the end of the year,
that's gonna happen. That's easy.
That's 250,000 people.
I got you.
Okay.
I'll tweet it.
All right. So no matter what the circumstance, make sure you always and forever keep it
tight.
Yeah.
Look at your boy.
Yeah, look at it. Oh, I gotta say who made them. Okay. Say. Check it out. Flaming Toast stickers.
Oh my God. Coolest name ever.
Sick, right? They hooked me up. Some of this, boom, my boy at Nerds Clothing Company sent me a surprise with all these stickers, all this
so
stuff.
Cool.
He's the man. Yeah, there it is. Keep it tight. Tell him.
Keep it tight.
Yeah.